climate change is a thing that's a real thing, but the real problem is the overall impact of an individual economy on it is still a little bit questionable, in my opinion. But a lot of the accords that have been written out there were written more from the standpoint of international politics than actual practicality and for the people that they're intended to serve. So I have never been a favor of, say, Paris Accords, not been a favor of Kyoto or a lot of those other treaties that were out there that were simply unenforceable.
I think it's been incredibly positive what this president has done in not only removing us from the Paris Climate Accord, but also in the first month of his presidency, the Trans-Pacific Partnership. I think that there's a misnomer, a misconception that conservatives, that Republicans like myself, don't care about the environment. That parlays to our president as well, but he does.
Well, there's a lot of people that are going to disagree with me, but I think Obama and presidents of the past have overstepped their boundaries. And I think Trump, being a pro-growth and pro-business president, was within his right to abolish some of these unnecessary regulations. For these businesses that are coming up, they need to have a safe harbor as far as what to expect from government regulation, what's right and what's wrong, what they can do and what they can't do when they open up a business.
I didn't really care much for the Paris Climate Treaty. I think it was lopsided. You know, we always end up paying for everything and taking a burden of the regulations, why a lot of them, get grandfathered in or don't be checked for many years down the road. And there always seems to be the fine print for other nations. And I think President Trump looked out for us.
I think that it's been a big part of why our economy has done better. I think the idea is not to get rid of, these energy sources we have now. I think the idea is to be able to make them cleaner, find ways to reduce carbon emissions and have clean water and all that. And I don't think you can basically take a whole industry and get rid of it or tax it into submission.
Oh, I think they've been positive. All those deals that we have with all those other countries, all they've done was shaft us. They cut our coal production. They cut our pollution for our factories. And then they went ahead and burned coal, and they've done all those things. We don't control all the world's air and the cleanliness of the air and the water. If everybody's not on board and they're just cutting us and making us have regulations, and China and Russia and the Europeans don't abide by the rules, and then we have to pay for it without jobs and without people working, we become the laughingstock.